Okay, so once again, what constitute IT infrastructure and what are the constituent components, no? The IT infrastructures refers to the collective technological resources that serve as the foundation for the specific information system applications employed by an organization. The IT infrastructure, no, encompasses a range of resources, including hardware, software, and services, which are co collectively utilized throughout the entirety of the organizations. The primary constituents of IT infrastructures encompass computer hardware platforms, operating systems platforms, enterprise software platform, networking and telecommunication platforms, database management software, internet platforms, as well as consulting services and system integrators. So, what are the many stages and technological factors that drive the evolutions of IT infrastructure? The IT infrastructure evolutions encompasses five distinct stages: the mainframe era and the personal computer era, the client service era, the enterprise computing era, and the cloud and mobile computing era. Moore's law, no, pertains to exponential growth in computational capacity and concurrent reductions in the cost of computer technology. So it posits that the processing power of microprocessor doubles every 18 months, while the price of computing experiences a corresponding halving. No? The law of mass digital storage pertains to the phenomenon of the exponential reductions in the economic costs associated with data storage, wherein the quantity of kilobytes of data that can be stored on magnetic media at a unit cost of $1 about doubles every 15 months. So Metcalfe's law demonstrates the exponential growth in value that occurs for participants inside a network as the number of members increases. Furthermore, the decreasing cost of communications and the increasing consensus within the technology industry to adapt computing and communication standards are other factors contributing to the proliferations of a computer usage. Now, what are the prevailing patterns in computer hardware platforms at present? There is a growing trend towards the utilization of mobile digital platforms for computing purposes. A while ago, our presenter mentioned about grid computing. Grid computing is a process that entails the interconnections of computers located in different geographical locations to form a unified network. And this network, known as a computational grid, effectively harnesses the collective processing capabilities of all computers involved. Virtualization is a process that enables the efficient utilizations of computing resources by removing limitations imposed, by physical configurations or geographical locations. On the other hand, cloud computing refers to the practice of acquiring computing resources and software applications as services through a network such as the internet. Instead of procuring and deploying the necessary hardware and software on the individual computer systems, no? A multi-core processor refers to a microprocessor that has been augmented with two or more processing cores in order to achieve improved performance. So, green computing encompasses a range of activities and technologies aimed to mitigating the adverse environmental effects or effects associated with the production, utilization, and disposal of information technology gear. Autonomic computing encompasses computer systems that possess inherent ability to autonomously configure and repair themselves. So, power-saving CPUs have the capacity to significantly decrease power consumptions in mobile digital devices. So, what are the prevailing patterns when it comes to mass software platforms at present? So, our presenter mentioned about Linux and different, So, open source software is developed and sustained by a worldwide community of programmers, and it is frequently available for free download. So, Linux nga po is an open source operating system known for its robustness and versatility, capable for functioning on various hardware platforms. So, it is extensively employed for the operation of web servers. Java is a programming language that is widely used for web development due to its operating system and hardware interdependence or independence. It is recognized as the foremost interactive programming environment for the World Wide Web because web services are software components that are loosely connected and adhere to open web standards. They are designed to be compatible with any application, program, and operating system. They have the potential to serve as integral elements of internet-based application, facilitating the connections between the operational frameworks of two distinct entities, or enabling the integrations of diverse systems within a singular organization. Right now, as of today, organizations are acquiring their novel software applications from external sources, which encompass software packages through the practice of outsourcing custom application development to an external vendor, no, perhaps located abroad, or by availing online software services through the software as a service model. Mashups, no, include the integration of two distinct software services in order to generate novel software applications and services. So applications also referred to as an apps, no, we are all aware, no. This will be our compact software programs designed to operate on various platforms such as the internet, computers, or mobile phones. And these applications are typically distributed and accessed via the internet. So, what are the inherent difficulties associated with the administration of IT infrastructure and management solution? Right now, no, the primary obstacle encompass addressing platform infrastructure modification, effectively managing and governing infrastructure, and making prudent investment in infrastructures. So the recommended approach entails employing a competitive forces model to ascertain the appropriate allocation financial resources towards IT infrastructure and identifying critical areas to infrastructure investment. Additionally, it is crucial to estimate the total cost of ownership associated with information technology assets because the comprehensive expenses associated with technology resource ownership encompass not solely the initial investment in computer hardware and software, but also encompass costs pertaining to hardware and software upgrades, maintenance, technical support, and training. So I think that's it for chapter 5. No? So we are all aware, no, with different infrastructures, no, and so on, no, different IT infrastructures in our offices, no, or even in your respective schools, if you are presently connected to the schools, and in a government agency, of course, no, they just also, especially right now in the Philippines, the ICT will be the one who in charge for IT infrastructure, no. Most commonly, no, when it comes to the use of data IT collects, no, as what our presenter mentioned, we have Google Search, we have Gmail, DoubleClick, YouTube, no, mobile maps with my locations, my Google Toolbar, no, Google Bus, Google Chrome, Google Checkout, Google Analytics, and a lot more, no. So kailangan talaga we are all aware, no, all available apps, no, in ano, but accountability, liability, and control must consider, no, along with privacy and property laws. No? So it is important for us to be, of course, consider all those things. No, hindi pwedeng, dapat always use technology with care, no, and considering all the possible pros and cons, no, of technologies in our workplace, no, even at home, no, especially ano, right now. And ano pa ba? So I think that's it now for today. So before I forget, no, don't forget to answer all the activities available in our books, no. So per chapter there are essay questions that you need to answer and send it to our Google Drive. Okay? So, as part of your quiz. So,